Come back or stick around or whatever, but we hope to see you. for that. And then we're going to go to the pumpkin patch.
Amen. All right. Any other announcements? Yes, ma'am.
Starts off. So being a good steward is about sharing our time, talent, resource, and treasure with God and others. Christian stewards serve God faithfully, remembering those they are, whose they are, and why they are here on earth. Today we passed out the pledge cards for 2025. Please prayerfully consider what you are able to give. We'd like to have them back in 2 weeks. You can leave them in the offering tray or by the offering trays, and or put them in Bonnie's office if you want to come in this week. The stewardship committee will start working on the budget this week. This year we did something different. Included with the beautiful, brilliant letter that Mary Carol wrote, you really should read it, is a list of some of the activities and organizations that we sponsor. It's part of where the money goes to, with your support for the church. Outreach is a very important part of our faith, and also taking care of each other. So thank you for your help.
Amen. Thank you. Any other announcements? Anything else going on today, this week, in the near future? Can't think of any. You all heard about the great devastation caused by Hurricane Helene. Week of Compassion is at work there. That's our, it's kind of like the part of our denomination that works with people in crises, especially on usually a grand scale. There's a famine somewhere or a horrible storm or something or forest fires. They are there helping people on the ground. And the great thing about Week of Compassion, I can't remember the exact percentage, should have prepared this better, but anyway, most of your money, like 90%+ of your money goes directly to people on the ground. It's not ran by somebody who makes seven figures, so like some other cares. So yes, your money goes directly to people in need. And so if you want to make a donation to Week of Compassion, just put on your check, put Hurricane Relief on the memo line, just Hurricane. Jamie, he's the one who handles the donations. He told me to do this the other day, so he'll know what it means. If you want to put Week of Compassion Hurricane on it, just to be sure, you can do that. Or if you want to give cash, we have envelopes available. We put an envelope, right, Hurricane Relief on it, and it'll get to Week of Compassion. That way the church can just send one check. All right, any other announcements? I know Joyce Jones, she's home and doing all right. She said her heart feels strong. She can tell it's working better than it has in a long, long time. She does have a couple other things going on, nothing life-threatening, but just continue to keep Joyce in your prayers. Anybody else you need to pray for? Prayer concerns?
Elaine.
Oh yes, Elaine is staying home today. She is feeling very weak, so continue to pray for Elaine. Anyone else need to? Yes.
I'm with that Charlene. Her dad, Gerald, himself is not good. He's just prostate cancer, and he's in a wheelchair.
Right.
So just pray for her.
Pray for Charlene and Gerald. Okay. Charlene is Gerald's dad.
Oh,
I mean, Gerald is Charlene's dad. That makes more sense. Gerald sounds like a dad. Yeah. All right. But hey, whatever. Anybody else we need to pray for? Or anybody have a joy? Anyone have a joy to share? Shirley Knightley's birthday party was phenomenal yesterday. In the fellowship halls. Just, we had a full house. She seemed to be having a really good time, so that was That was nice. And then I got to go to Mary Deal's birthday out at her daughter and son-in-law's house. Yes.
She turned 100, and there was a card out on the table in the narthex.
Yeah.
And you like decided for
her. Yeah. I think they decided they're gonna celebrate her birthday all year.
All year. Yeah.
All year long.
We have to celebrate every day.
Every day.
Get to our
yes.
Cake every day.
Amen. That's the way to do it. So I celebrate. Yeah. I guess I'm celebrating my birthday every day.
Right.
Why not? Heck yeah. Any other joys or concerns? Yes. All right. Well, let's get to it. Do what we came here to do. Let's worship Almighty God. Please join me now in our affirmation of faith.
I believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God, and I confess Him as Lord and Savior in my life.
Sun, big blue sky. We give you thanks that we can be here. in your house today with our brothers and sisters in Christ, and we humbly ask that your Spirit would be here with us still, each of us, Lord. Make your presence known here among us. And today, Lord, we continue to ask your blessing on everyone who is recovering from Hurricane Elaine. We ask for peace and comfort for those folks and all the aid workers, all the linemen, everybody that's involved in getting their lives back to some sense of, give them some sense of normalcy. Giving them food and shelter, everything they need to live and to thrive. Today we also ask your blessing upon Joyce. We give you thanks for her successful surgery and continue to ask for healing for her. We also ask for healing for Elaine and peace and comfort and strength for her. We also ask for your blessing upon Charlene and Gerald. We ask for comfort for them both and healing for Gerald. Lord, today we also ask your blessing upon our stewardship campaign. We give you thanks for all the faithful stewards in our congregation. Give you thanks for all the support that the ministries of this church receives, and we ask your blessings upon all of them. We give you thanks also for weak and compassionate and all the important work they do all over the world. Lord, we give you thanks that you are our rock, that we can be rooted in you, that we have an unshakable, unbreakable foundation in you. And we give you thanks for this in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Scripture today comes from the Gospel according to Luke, chapter 6, verses 46 to 49. The word of the Lord. Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and do not do what I tell you? I will show you what someone is like when he comes to me, hears my words, and acts on them. That one is like a man building a house who dug deeply and laid the foundation on rock. When a flood arose, the river burst against the house but could not shake it because it had been well built. But the one who hears and does not act is like a man who built a house on the ground without a foundation. When the river burst against it, immediately it fell, and great was the ruin of that house. The word of the Lord. Well, in recent days, we've learned that a house can be well built with a firm foundation on rock and still be washed away. But Jesus is pointing to something much deeper here. And it's the not-so-obvious theme of, or a not-so-obvious theme of the Sermon on the Plain, which we've been going through for, I think this is the fifth week now, maybe. We're going to wrap it up today. Yeah, that is the end of the Sermon on the Plain right there. But back at the very beginning of the sermon, very beginning, Jesus said, "Blessed are you who are poor, for yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are you who are hungry now, for you will be filled. Blessed are you who weep now, you will laugh. Blessed are you when people hate you, and when they exclude you, revile you, and defame you on account of the Son of Man. Rejoice on that day and leap for joy. For surely your reward is great in heaven, for that is what their ancestors did to the prophets. But woe to you who are rich, for you have received your consolation. Woe to you who are full now, for you will be hungry. Woe to you who are laughing now, for you will mourn and weep. Woe to you who, when all speak well of you, for that is what their ancestors did to the false prophets. But I say to you that listen, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, pray for those who abuse you. If anyone strikes you on the cheek, offer the other also. And from anyone who takes away your coat, do not withhold even your shirt. Give to everyone who begs from you. And if anyone takes away your goods, do not ask for them again. Do to others as you would have them do to you. If you love those who love you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners love those who love them. If you do good to those who do good to you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners do the same. If you lend to those from whom you hope to receive, what credit is that to you? Even sinners lend to sinners and to receive as much again. But love your enemies, do good, and lend, expecting nothing in return. Your reward will be great, and you will be children of the Most High. For he is kind to the ungrateful and the wicked. Be merciful as your Father is merciful. Do not judge, and you will not be judged. Do not condemn, and you will not be condemned. Forgive, and you will be forgiven. Give, and it will be given to you. A good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will be put in your lap. For the measure you give will be the measure you give back. Amen. Yes, that is most of the Sermon on the Plain. Right there. And I thought, we've heard many of those verses over the past few weeks, but I thought it would be good to hear them all together and in context, and to know that that only sounded completely logical to very few people over the centuries. I imagine that's why Jesus, the scripture reading today, began with Jesus saying to his disciples, "Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and you not do what I tell you?" Yeah, it was tough even for those 12 guys. Well, there technically could have been more. He named the 12 apostles right before he gave the sermon, but there could have been, you know, some junior disciples. Anyways, it appears that even, no, I just said that. I imagine he said that, yeah, because it's tough for them. Oh man, I got so lost. I think why it's so tough is because that theme, that not so obvious theme that Jesus is trying to teach us is letting go. It's teaching us to let go. Yes, we must be willing to let go of our possessions, our money, our pride, our enmity, and instead cling to that which is eternal, like love and mercy and faith. Faith in God and also faithfulness to God. Yes, if our foundation, what we cling to, is things, is stuff, we will absolutely lose it all. And if that's what we care about most, money and things, and we have them in abundance, we've made it. This is as good as it gets. But there is so much more in Christ. Yes, if our foundation is in faith in Jesus Christ, which leads to love for all, then we have an eternal home in God's kingdom, and nothing can take that away. And I know it can be hard to let go. There are some things that are just really tough to let go of, but it's not impossible. Reminds me of this trap I heard about. I think it was in India. And they use it to catch monkeys. It's the most humane trap I've ever heard of. I mean, it really is. They take a coconut, They cut a hole in the coconut, they put a banana inside the coconut, and they like, somehow they attach the coconut to a tree or something. So the monkey comes along, reaches in, grabs the banana, and can't get his hand out. If you let go of the banana, his hand would slip out, but because his hand makes a fist, he can't get it out. And those dang monkeys, they will just sit there and hold on to that banana. And guys will just come up and grab them and put them in a cage. Like, they will not let go. They want that banana so bad. All the other monkeys are running off, and they're just like, I am going to get this banana. No matter what. They can be free. All they got to do is let go and run with the other monkeys to freedom. But no, that banana is too important to them. They will not let go. So we gotta not be silly monkeys and be aware. It's something I've talked about through this sermon on the plane is to take some introspection. We gotta find our bananas. What are our bananas? What are the things we won't let go of? What are those things? Because we can let go. We can be free. So free. That's what Jesus is calling us to. This glorious freedom, but we get so hung up on things. Get things stuck in our craw, so to speak. It's numerous things that can trap us. But look for those. Look for those bananas. Don't be a monkey and wind up in a cage. And another thing about letting go, when it comes to our possessions, our money, I think in a way our culture, experience warns us that if we do something like that, we could end up living in a van down by the river, or worse. Yes, you give away all your stuff, you're going to have nothing. But it doesn't have to be so black and white. It doesn't have to necessarily be a thoroughly awful outcome, because God is with us through the whole process. No matter what, God is with us. Whatever He calls us to do, He's still with us. And I know it sounds scary, the possibility of our livelihood, our income, our possessions being taken away or the lost. But Jesus wants us, or is telling us, to let go of fear as well. We don't have to be afraid. It reminds me of what He said in Luke chapter 12, verses 32 to 34. Do not be afraid, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. I think that's might be my favorite. It's definitely my top 10 favorite scriptures. Or favorite single verse. Do not be afraid, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Sell your possessions and give alms. Make purses for yourselves that do not wear out. An unfailing treasure in heaven, or wherever it is, where no thief comes near and no moth destroys. For where your treasure is, your heart will be also. Yes. So cling to faith in Jesus and all that entails. Love, hope, peace, joy, freedom. And be willing to let go of everything else. And you will be on solid rock forever and ever. Amen. And if you would like to become a member of this congregation, we ask you to come forward during our communion hymn. Thank you. As it was on the night when our Lord was betrayed, Jesus said, he took bread, And when he given thanks, he broke it. He said, this is my body, but it's for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And in the same way, after supper, he took the cup. He said, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as we eat this bread and drink the cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Let us pray. Gracious and loving Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for this opportunity to dine at your Son's table. And we ask your blessing upon the bread and the cup and all who partake of this. And we give you thanks for the eternal life which we have received in your Son's name. And we give you thanks for this in his name. Amen. Come to the table. Please pray with me. Holy and loving God, we give you thanks for this time to worship you. We give you thanks for the great feast at your Son's table. And we pray that your Spirit be with us. Go with us. Guide us. Help us to cling to our faith in Jesus Christ first and foremost. And we ask this in his name. Amen.